So just checking in with your body, asking it if there's anything it needs to be more comfortable or at ease. Allowing kindfulness to just sweep down the body. Noticing each body part. Any sensations. Regarding them with kindly eyes. As though your body were a very dear friend. Selflessly looking after you, serving you, doing its best to keep you well. Spending a few minutes showing appreciation and care for your own body. Noticing how that loving attention helps relax the sensations, the pain, the tensions. Even the irritations in the nose and the throat. Giving them space to be there. For those of you who have not yet practiced with a difficult person, we're going to start again with the loved or benevolent person. But before beginning, just see if you'd like to choose a difficult person. Keep them in your pocket, so to speak, in case you want to bring them up later in the meditation. And choose somebody whom you have perhaps a difficult relationship with, or who you don't like very much, who you sometimes maybe find it hard to feel compassion toward. But not anybody who's really hurt or harmed you. So don't take too big a challenge. When you start to recall the difficult person, see if you can connect with one or two qualities that are still good in this person. And if that's difficult, then at very least, reflect that they too desire their own happiness. Perhaps sometimes in unskillful ways. Perhaps they're sometimes unaware of the hurt that they cause to others. But in their own way, they're also, just like us, wish to be happy. when you've chosen the difficult person, just let that go and start building the metta, beginning with the loved or the benefactor. And moving towards yourself. And if you find that the metta is flowing quite well, you can bring in the neutral person. So just practice with these three for the first part of this meditation. Noticing the effect it has in your own heart, in your emotional world. And allowing that to be. Keep on connecting with the meaning of those phrases. The purity of the intention. And trusting the power of that intention. To stir the metta in your own heart. for just checking in with your heart. See if it would like to stay with the other objects you're already practicing with. Or if the metta's flowing strongly and evenly, and the mind feels ready, you may like to bring to mind the difficult person. Remaining to connect it to your heart, to your emotions. And understanding that if any strong, difficult emotions come up, you can either stay with these with kindfulness, with acceptance, or if it's too much, you can always go back to giving yourself loving kindness, or go back to the loved one. Whatever it is you need to do to take care of yourself. gently letting the difficult person fade. With a smile. Letting the neutral person and the loved person fade. Remaining connected to your heart, to your body. Just bring that metta back to yourself. It's a beautiful gift towards yourself. Appreciating the courage it takes to open the heart, to meet anything painful or difficult. And silently thanking your body, your mind, your heart. Being willing to do the work. Just allowing your kind attention to spread through the body, filling it up, as though filling the body with a golden light. Healing any aches or pains, any irritations in the throat or the nose. From this connection with your body, expanding your awareness to fill the room, flowing out to the people sitting beside you, opposite, and sensing yourself as part of this circle of metta. Experiencing the support. Sense of being part of that support.